Hey, when you are using disks for your Windows Server 2008 file server, you may need to configure those disks depending on, this is particularly relevant if you're installing new disks after the operating system has been installed. So what things do you need to be able to do with the disks that you've installed on your server? Well, you need to select a partitioning style, and you're going to need to be able to choose between a master boot record partition style and a GUID partition style. You need to select the disk type between basic versus dynamic. You need to be able to divide the disk into either partitions or volumes. Depending on if you have a basic disk, you could break your disk up into partitions. If it's a dynamic disk, they're called volumes. And lastly, you need to be able to select the file system. Is this going to be the NTFS file system, the FAT file system, which includes FAT16 and FAT32, which are older file systems that are needed for backwards compatibility as well as interoperability with other operating systems.